Good morning, friends. Mark Holmes here with my buddy Cowboy Joe Boo, as well as Joe Bear in the house. And as always, I want to thank you all for watching, commenting, subscribing, and being part of the Joe Boo Sports Report. Without you guys, this literally does not work. So let's get open for business here. And let's wake up those football gods. Wake up here, guys. Wake up here on this Taco Tuesday. And if Taco Tuesday wasn't enough to make it a nice day, we get a little bit extra today because there's nothing better than seeing the Philadelphia Eagles get their butts whipped, get their lunch handed to them, get their teeth kicked in, to get run over by a Mack truck, and for Carson Wentz, the quarterback that they prop up more than any other quarterback in the NFL, to see that guy look really, really bad. You know, sometimes it's better to remain quiet and let people think that you're an idiot as opposed to actually saying something and letting people know that you're an idiot. Last night, before the game, Jim Schwartz said he complimented DJ Metcalf. DJ Metcalf, who has been all that in a ham sandwich since he got drafted by Seattle. Incredible talent. He told him he had a ton of respect for him. Because he worked with Calvin Johnson, of course, in Detroit and things. And he's the closest thing to Megatron he's seen, but he's not there yet. DJ Metcalf said, I took that personally. And DJ Metcalf went off. He went off on them. I mean, literally. He made Slay look like, just made him look like some crap. He literally beat down Slay like he stole something. And, you know, as crazy as it is, you know, the Seattle Seahawks tried to give them, you know, give them opportunities. They went for it fourth down, you know, in the red zone, and they went for it another time on like their 38, 39-yard line and didn't convert either time. And these were momentum-changing type plays, but the Eagles could not convert on them. Their first five possessions, they got 4 yards. 4 yards. Now, the edict going down to Doug Peterson, who it looks like is trying to get fired, was if Carson Wentz struggles, play Hurts more. Now, they played Hurts for a couple of plays, but they didn't have any rhyme or reason to him. The only thing you were doing was messing up the psyche of your quarterback. Your quarterback, who by definition is the worst. You talk about dinking and dunking. 4.78 yards per completion against the worst secondary in football. The worst secondary in football. Only 55.56 completion rate. That's just bad. That team, that coaching staff, they are under the microscope. But wait, if you're an Eagle fan, there's some good news. There's actually great news if you're an Eagle fan because you moved up in the tankathon. You are now up to 6. And dare I say, because you see, you're right here. Let me pull this up a little closer. There you are right there at the 6th spot. That half game keeping you right there. Here we are at the 4th spot, which in essence actually makes Eagles-Cowboys game kind of important. We will actually be playing for something when we play. You know, right now, of course, Washington is right here, and as happy as Cop Pizzle is right now that his team, that they're in first place. Here's what's crazy when we start thinking about this, okay? We have Washington at the 8th spot at 4-7. But you go all the way down, because the Giants are actually leading the division, they're in the 19th spot. That's a big difference between the two. So winning division and having that first place schedule next year just kind of makes it that win probably short-lived. The reality is this is what's crazy. If this was any other division, any other division, you're talking about being 4-7, you'd be in the bottom of the division. Our division is historically bad. I don't know that there's ever been a division that has literally been this bad. We've got to go back and see, because this is crazy. This is insane. The fact that there are 14 victories in the whole division for the season is just awful. So this ends up making the Cowboys versus the Eagles game the battle for that top five draft pick. Now, I look at it with the Eagles schedule. Let me pull it up real quick. I'm sorry, I don't have it up here. The Eagles schedule, it gets to be brutal. You know, after playing against Seattle, come Sunday on a short week, they have to play the Packers. Then they got to play the Saints. Then they have to play the Cardinals and then us. It's very conceivable that they lose all three of those games. Now, as far as my Cowboys, of course, we have a couple of games that we may be able to win going forward. It's conceivable that we beat Cincinnati. I'm not saying that we will. Ravens game, you know, with them playing on a short week, hopefully getting some of their players back, that would be a tough game for us to win on the road. But we have the Bengals, and the Bengals, you know, they're not real good. I know that the Giants are feeling great right now, feeling themselves about winning against the Bengals. But let's be honest here, Giants, the Bengals aren't good. They don't have their rookie starting quarterback, and you barely beat them. So enjoy yourselves. Be proud of yourselves. You did what you needed to do to take care of the division. But the Bengals aren't that good. Now, it's conceivable the Cowboys could get a win there, in which case then, you know, we're one up on the Eagles. I don't see the Eagles being able to win any of those games between now and the Cowboys. I'll be honest with you. If you can't get more than 215 yards, I believe it is, 215 yards, and probably 60 of that was garbage time yards against the worst secondary in football, I don't think the Eagles win another game, and then it's basically the Cowboys versus the Eagles for draft position. I mean, if I'm wrong, tell me I'm wrong. But I don't see much for the Eagles to salvage right there. Now, for our Cowboys, I'm not saying that we got a whole lot to hang our hats on after, you know, Washington stomped on us again a second time, especially in that fourth quarter. And as we look at some of the coaching decisions that were made by Doug Peterson, we've got our own coaching decisions that we have to question as well. But I do believe that the Cowboys have an advantage over next year, because we'll get our quarterback back next year, provided Jerry Jones isn't an idiot. Eagles, I'm curious if, for the Eagles, if next week Jalen Hurts doesn't get the start. I don't know how you don't sit Carson Wentz down now against Green Bay. And as much as I kid and joke and stuff on there, you got to feel bad for Carson Wentz. I mean, it's bad. He's got receivers that are dropping the ball. His ball placement is terrible. He's holding on to the ball too long. He's got the coaching and everything else. But when you are the franchise quarterback, as we know with Dak Prescott, you get all the blame, or you should. And I can't wait to see how and if the talking heads softball it on Carson Wentz today. So that's where we are right now. The Dallas Cowboys will get prepared to take on the Baltimore Ravens next Tuesday, their very first Tuesday night game at 8:05. That'll be interesting to see that one. Hey, can't wait, actually. So close, I almost wish I could be there, but there's no fans in the stands. I'm Mark Holmes, and well, I look forward to that two-day after Christmas contest between the Eagles and the Cowboys for draft position. And I'll see you guys soon.